So let us continue our discussion. We are in question number 1, part E. Before answering the question, let me remind you about refractive index. So here in my diagram, I have made two media. This is medium 1 and this one is medium 2. Optical density of these two media are different. That means in this medium light travels with one particular speed, and in this medium same light will travel with a different speed. Okay. So consider a ray of light which falls on the surface of separation. So this incident ray travels with a speed v1 angle, and then it enters the second medium. Quite naturally, it will bend. Okay, suppose it bends like this. Why does it bend? Because speed of light in the medium 2 is different. So let it be. Let the speed be v2. Okay. You remember that famous wave equation? Yes, v is equal to f lambda. If you want, you can write this in terms of frequency and the wavelength. It will be like this, f1 lambda, isn't it? V is equal to f lambda. So here it is frequency of light in the first medium into wavelength of light in the first medium. So here I can write f2 lambda. Okay? Frequency of light in the second medium into wavelength of light in the second medium. Well, but you know that when light travels from one medium to another medium, speed changes and of course wavelength changes, but frequency remains the same. So here I can write f lambda 1, and here also I can use the same f. Isn't it? Okay. Remember this. Now let me tell you something else regarding one ratio, very important. This ratio v1 by v2. Velocity of light in first medium divided by velocity of light in the second medium has a special name. What is that name? Refractive index. We will say refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium. The symbol we use for refractive index is N. But in many books, you will come across another symbol, mu also. Okay, let me go for that symbol then. I will use here mu. Like this. Okay, so what does it mean? Ratio of velocity of light in first medium to the velocity of light in second medium is called refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium. Now this refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium, I can write like this also, f lambda 1 divided by f lambda 2. Am I correct? Yes. Instead of v1, I wrote this f lambda 1. Instead of v2, I wrote f lambda 2. That implies this refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium is equal to f, and f gets cancelled. Lambda 1 by lambda 2. So this relation, please remember this relation. Refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium, basically that is ratio of velocity of light in first medium to the velocity of light in the second medium, or it can be taken like this also. Okay. Well, then let us go for their question. The wavelength of light in a medium A is 600 nanometer. So one medium is there. Let me call that medium A. This is medium B. Okay. Here wavelength of light is 600 nanometer. Okay. The wave enters medium B with a refractive index 1.5. So entering into the second medium with a refractive index 1.5. So refractive index of a second medium with respect to first medium. In this case, refractive index of B with respect to A is 1.5. So velocity of light is decreasing, isn't it? Oh, it is like this. V1 by, so here I can write VA by VB. That is equal to this at 1.5. 1.5 means I can write 3 by 2. 3 by 2 is 1.5 only. So velocity of light in this second medium B is equal to, when I rearrange, what will I get? I will get a 2 by 3 times of VA. Velocity of light in medium B is 2/3 of velocity of light in medium A. So velocity of light is decreasing. Okay. When velocity of light decreases, it bends towards the normal. Okay. This will be the case. So we will understand this much from their statement. What? The wave enters medium B of refractive index 1.5 with respect to medium A. Then, okay. The question. Select the correct option from the following. First one. The wavelength of light becomes 1.5 times the initial wavelength. Okay, what they are given? The refractive index of medium B with respect to A is 1.5. That means we have already seen that relation, isn't it? Wavelength of light in this medium, A divided by wavelength of light in B. That is equal to 1.5. 1.5 means 3 by 2. So wavelength of light becomes 1.5 times the initial wavelength. No. This, when you rearrange, you will get this one is equal to 2 by 3 into wavelength of light in medium A. So wavelength of light is not becoming 1.5 times. Wavelength of light becomes, actually it is 0.67 times of wavelength of A, isn't it? So their first statement is wrong. Second one, the wavelength of light decreases. Oh, that is true. It becomes 2/3 of wavelength of light in A. So wavelength of light decreases. That statement is correct. Let us go for the third option also. The wavelength becomes half of initial wavelength. No, we have seen that wavelength of light becomes 2/3 of the wavelength of the light in medium A. Not half. Fourth one, the wave bends away from the normal. No. So the answer is which option? The wavelength of light decreases. Okay. Now next one, the wavelength in medium B will be, you have to calculate that. Once again, refractive index of medium B with respect to A is equal to 1.5. That implies wavelength of light in medium A divided by wavelength of light in medium B is equal to 3 by 2. 2 times of lambda A, cross multiplying, is equal to 3 times of lambda B. I need to find lambda B. So lambda B is equal to 2 by 3 times lambda A. Isn't it? That's equal to 2 by 3 times wavelength of light in a medium A. That is given 600 nanometer. 600 nanometer is equal to what? 400 nanometer. So, answer is there 400 nanometer. Next question. Let us do that.